tomorrow. Might be counting dough. I'll bet with your, Okay, your nose keep running and the money keep coming. Hey, I'ma keep ballin', hey. Rock a park, spawning, hey. Carefree, I've been living carefree. So much in the air, we can barely even breathe. Hey. I really worry about things I don't know.
On EA Sports. The Niners come into today's matchup wanting to find a way to walk out of the stadium with win number 5 on the season. It's the Patriots going up against the 49ers. With that, let's get out west to Santa Clara, where we say hello to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, we are down the peninsula from San Francisco as you get a look inside modern Levi Stadium in Santa Clara. Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the New England Patriots and the San Francisco 49ers. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. They'll come out in the pistol. Here's the first carry now for the tailback, Roddy Hillman. And he powers his way up past the 30. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down. The starting 11 on your screen now, and the one we discuss is Torrey Smith.
You would do worse than to just call long pass plays and throw it to Torrey Smith. He can certainly take the top off of any defense.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. They keep it on the ground. Hillman. And he's brought down. The offensive line and its ability to open holes in this defensive front, something they were confident they could create in this game, got the job done there, picked up the first.
And something they wanted to do. Have we ever met offensive linemen that don't want to fire out and hit people? I mean, they love the running game. Guys want to do that. And when you emphasize it, practice it, and work on it, that gives you an opportunity during the game.
And his throw is going to be incomplete. Cody Latimer, the intended receiver. And now it's second down. And quickly, let's check out the New England defense.
Rob Ninkovich is one of those great gems that got polished up over time. Whether he's rushing as a defensive end or playing outside linebacker, he's awfully productive.
Kaepernick again here on second and 10. Finding his target, it's Cody Latimer. A really nice gain of 25 yards. And Cap, of course, was a great baseball player, drafted as a pitcher. He kind of showed his arm right there, didn't he?
Yeah, he let that one go, didn't he? That was a catcher putting down the number one signal for the fastball and turning it loose. It was needed in that situation, though. He had to throw a tight spiral and a hard one in order to get it in there for a completion.
To throw, Kaepernick. This will be caught at about the three. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Their dangerous wide receiver. His third touchdown now on the year. And the 49ers drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. After the touchdown, it's Dawson on to kick it away. And this will be a touchback. Last year would have come out to the 20. This year they'll move it out to the 25-yard line. First and 10, here's Brady. Quickly to Gronkowski, that's caught. He'll give him a yard on the play, and that'll bring up second down. And we roll now on the offensive starters, and everybody always loves to talk about Gronk.
And wouldn't a lot of teams love to redraft right now? This guy went in the second round, yet no matter what, you've got a game plan for him when you're opposing him.
Only a yard on the pickup, and now they've got a third down and 8. And a look now at the defensive starters for San Francisco.
Terrence Knighton's nickname, Pot Roast, was given to him, and he didn't like it at first. Now he says, don't call me Terrence. Holds down the middle against anyone trying to run the football.
Dumps it off to Lewis. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
Ah, that's tough to play zone defense when they can just curl up right there in front of you.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we talk about finding the soft spot defensively. How do you make sure they don't find the soft spot like they did there?
Tough to do, because what they normally will do is run routes that'll pull you out of that spot they want to get into. That's what we call it, not taking the cheese, right? Don't go for the mousetrap. It's hard to do, because when you see a guy cutting that in that direction, you tend to go towards him.
Again, here's Bill. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. Boy, that's a lot of sirloin steak to be taken down for no gain, partner.
Are you trying to suggest that he is a huge man?
He is.
Not just a big man,
big,
a huge man.
Big, big boy.
Well, how about the credit then for the defense to be able to chop that big tree and put him on the ground?
I know back when you played, it took four of you to take a guy like that down, right?
Well, that's for sure. And you know what else? I didn't want to challenge him at dinner either.
On fourth down, on now is the lefty Ryan Allen to punt. Fielded just inside the 20. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt, and the Niners will go on offense, first and 10. The San Francisco offense getting their last-minute instructions before they take over here. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
On second down, Hillman. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. And he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. And maybe something in the defense that got Kaepernick's attention as he's going to call a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And the offense lining up first and 10. Down, Kaepernick. Over the middle here to Brown. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. How do you get much more balance than this? Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
One receiver left, two to the right. Throwing on first down is Kaepernick. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. Call it a gain of 3. And it's a second down. Here we go with 2nd and 7. Kaepernick throwing on 2nd down. And that one got tipped. Kind of threw everything off. It brings up 3rd.
Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. But for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try and knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab him. That'll be a holding penalty. So all you're trying to do is make some type of a play on him, make some type of contact to try and get his arms out of the sky.
On 3rd and long, it's Kaepernick. And Latimer's got it. And they're able to convert on 3rd with a solid gain of 23.
That crossing route is so effective when you hit it just right because you get a guy on the move, and then we see the end result there.
Nightmare for the defense. They got a guy with a full head of steam.
Not only does he catch it, but he picks up additional yardage after it.
And now a 1st down following that long gain. Back to the running game they go. It's Hillman. Ronnie Hillman, nothing but green grass ahead of him. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run. And one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
From the gun, it's Kaepernick. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. 13 yards there on the pickup, and the 49ers are going to get a first.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone, and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. This is Hillman on 1st and 10. No gain on the play there. 2nd down. Off the corner. Where'd he come from? Well, I guess he came off the corner, but really nice play.
I like when you're able to pose a question and answer it at the same time. That's exactly where he came from, but it's not something that you normally see. Most of the time, we're thinking about those guys covering pass catchers. In this case, he was a big factor in the run game. No gain.
Brown, the lone receiver left. On second down, here's Kaepernick. And this is caught by Smith. Touchdown, 49ers. Torrey Smith, his second touchdown on the season. And the 49ers add on to their lead. And it's good to make it 14-0. After the touchdown, it's Dawson on to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut it, all right? So you got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
Julian Edelman, the intended receiver, that'll bring up second down.
Let's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Sure looked like they were trying to hit the corner route.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. They slot Gronkowski outright. Brady again here on second and 10. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line.
I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old. You're only 65.
Again, it's Brady. The throw left side complete to Hogan. And he is going to lose yardage here. And a loss of 3 to bring up 4.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
This is brought in at the 21. Second quarter now. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis with you. It's the 49ers in control of the football as they take over following the punt with a first and 10. Again, we'll see the pistol here. They go play action here on first down. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he's brought down. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with a football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
It'll go as a gain of 10 there. And it'll be first down 49ers. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Hillman again, a first down carry. And this carry not as productive. He's swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. Jamal Sheard on the stop.
A 1-yard gain can look like a disaster, but all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
91. Check it back.
Kaepernick to throw on second down. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
I think that's a big-time play there because the slant route is really hard to cover because the timing is so quick. But able to see it, diagnose it, and get to the football, that's why he was able to bat it away.
And the offense looks to pick up the first here on third after that incompletion.
Hey, 91!
From the gun on third down, Kaepernick will dump it down to Hillman. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
There are a lot of tough routes to try and cover. When you see a runner come out of the backfield and run this angle route, looks like they're going to the flat, and then they put their foot in the ground and cut back sharply inside, not easily covered, and then when they catch it, good momentum built up by them as well.
And able to pick up the first. Kaepernick now on first down, eluding the pressure right. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And that one results in 35 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
Again, it's Kaepernick, and he fires one incomplete. Torrey Smith, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big-time drop.
Second and goal now from the 8. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Only a couple yards there, and that's going to set up a long third and goal.
I have to laugh a little bit because he actually handed it off. I thought with the 2 touchdown passes he's thrown in this one already, he'd go ahead and fling and try and get a third one.
Yeah, now from this spot on third down, I think he'd probably throw it here.
Yeah, I don't think there's any question about it. They won't even send in a running play here, I don't believe. I think they go ahead and try and throw it for a touchdown.
Throwing now is Kaepernick. This will be caught just inside the 10. It'll be a pickup of just 2, and that will bring up an interesting decision here on fourth and goal. The Niners call on Phil Dawson now for the field goal try on fourth down. From the left half, should be a fairly easy one here. And that field goal caps an 11-play drive.
That's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points, but they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
This will be fielded at the 8. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. And now out come the Patriots. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
And he dumps it off to Blunt. It's a 4-yard pickup, and that'll make it second down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
To throw, it's Brady going underneath to Blunt. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
throwing on first down is Brady. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
Good route, good pickup for first down yardage. And that is a tough one to cover, the angle route, because a running back getting out of the backfield, if you're trying to cover that, especially if you're in the linebacker spot and you're seeing this play develop, he heads out towards the flat first, and that often gets you to overcommit running in that direction. Then he cuts back up inside you into the middle of the field. That's what we just saw there for a nice pickup.
Brady to throw on second down. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. Third and two is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
But there's another example of why they haven't scored any points so far. I think it's time to abandon the run game, spread things out, and go to the air. It certainly can't be any worse than what they've done so far.
And he carries this one all the way down to the 9. They practiced this all week. Pretty clear it paid off there. Threw it downfield, made it look relatively easy.
And it always comes a little bit easier when you've practiced it and tuned things up and you're confident in what you're doing now.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Look at the big man rumble. Picked off by the linebacker, Eli Harold. 20, 10, 5, and into the end zone. A pick six for the 49er D as they score the touchdown. Short throw pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
This will be fielded at the 8. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help them a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back
in. But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
It'll be a gain of 6, and that'll lead here to a third down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
From the gun on third down, Brady. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. Now they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
A minute 58 to go in this first half of play. We'll come back here right after this. Shift together here from the D-line. The drive starts with a carry by Ronnie Hillman. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Credited with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
Now that's the type of play that'll fire up the defense. Hold them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all, or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
Hillman again. And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. So he loses 3 yards there. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime.
Strong
So now a third and 12 with an extra defender here in the secondary, a nickel look. On third and long, it's Kaepernick. And Latimer's got it. And he's brought down after a good game. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
Well, the advantage has certainly shifted to the defense as we began that third down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a first down.
Third time's a charm, right? Two incompletions. Had to have it on third, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
On first down, Ferguson. And he's going to get hit at the line of scrimmage and driven backwards. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
Now Kaepernick throwing on second down. Smith catches left side. And he's brought down. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Because Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
Think this has the carry. It does not. It's no good. Well, we're going to let you off a little easy there, LR. Halftime interrupted, and we are ready to get to this third quarter. This fielded at the 2. And not a particularly good return here as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line. So the Patriots coming out now. They come out here with a 0 on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution, or did they think just they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they felt they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out. Now Brady. And this one complete to Martellus Bennett. And able to get this one out just shy of the 25 at the 24.
Have we yet met a receiver that wasn't excited about getting a chance to play with Tom Brady?
Absolutely not.
And Martellus Bennett bringing his considerable skills to New England now. Going to hook up with Mr. Brady for another completion here.
Yeah, 90 catches a couple years ago in Chicago, 53 last year for Bennett. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Looking middle, and it's incomplete. The wideout, Chris Hogan, the intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down. So a second down incompletion now brings up third down.
If you're a defender, one of the fun things about playing zone defenses, especially in today's football, is that it's not as static as it.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. DeForest Buckner, the first round pick from Oregon, in there to get him for sack number 9 now on the year. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. This is taken at about the 14. An excellent return that time, 26 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Now how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion.
Well, on that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
Another pistol look here. Now Kaepernick operating on the bootleg. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
Kaepernick now on third and goal. And he connects with Vance McDonald. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be fourth down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they've rallied and made the tackle.
And now a high kick trying to pin him back. And he did get it back, I do think. Yes, so no turnover on the punt, and it'll be a first down. The Patriot offense now set to come back out on the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. They slot Gronkowski outright. Brady now on first down. Going underneath to Blunt. So a little grabbing there, but this time it goes against the offense for holding.
I really don't know where to go with this one. He caught the pass, but in the opposite direction towards his own end zone. That's not one you get every game.
From the gun, it's Brady. Going deep here for Edelman. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Now Brady throwing on second down. Screen pass to Blunt. Uses the stiff arm. It'll be a 2-yard gain. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
Now Brady, they will find his man. That's Hogan complete. 23 yards on the play.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
Looking middle, it's caught by Gronkowski. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. Call it a 3-yard gain, and that's going to bring up a third down. Still in search of the first down after that last completion. And defensively going with a dime set, six DBs on third and four. Here's Brady to throw, and that is incomplete. Danny Amendola, that was the intended target, and it's fourth and four. Gostkowski now for the Pats field goal try. From the left hash, it's an even 50-yard attempt. And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in three. A little bit of a lower trajectory there on the deep kick, and it worked.
Had to do it because he had to drive it out low because of the length of the kick. Able to do that, got it above the defense and over the post.
The 49er offense now making their way out onto the field. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet
and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well. Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Second down, 8. Possible run anticipation. Here's the D-line sandwiches together. On second down, here's Kaepernick. This time for Smith, and it's intercepted. Devin McCourty picks it off. And a return will be stopped at the 34-yard line. Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put 6 on the board here. We'll see. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. They'll get a couple yards on that one. And that'll make this a second down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Brady Gibbs now the ball. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. He lost 2 there. And it's third down.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
Brady now to throw, going underneath for Lewis. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Give him 9 on the play, and that'll bring up 4th down. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. From the left hash, he'll have to cut this at a tight angle. And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost, and the drive will wind up yielding 3. So give them 3 there. A good drive gets them inside the 5, but they couldn't punch it in.
And credit this defense, too. That was the old bend but don't break approach, but it kept the offense out of the end zone.
The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
6 yards to go here on second down. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. They'll run it now out of the gun. Cuts left. Ronnie Hillman, nothing but green grass ahead of him. Touchdown, 49ers. Ronnie Hillman, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the 49ers add 6 to their lead. Well called, well blocked, and then he just made a great play. That was an athlete going a long way.
Yeah, how about the suddenness, too, of just getting there and taking off and going? For the defensive guys, plays like that really hurt.
After the touchdown, it's Dawson on to kick it away. Danny Amendola on the return. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And the Patriots gearing up to go now. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. The first-round pick from a year ago, Eric Armstead, in there to sack him for a loss of 6. On second down, here's Brady. And now a fumble. Brady loses the football.
Plays like this, where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back.
because this is a quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. Now it looks like we've got a Patriot down, slow to get up. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. Here's Ryan Allen now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. This will be fielded at the 17. Good blocking there. Nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. It's a loss of four. Now third down.
Yeah, let me puff out my chest a little bit, even though I'm not rooting for either team. That was a really nice defensive play. It's awfully fun to watch, even in an offensive game.
Kaepernick now on third and goal. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Now Hillman, he has been active this afternoon. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
Well, he was stopped on that play, but he's had plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then, the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
They'll run it now out of the gun, and he is going to lose yardage here. It'll be a loss of one, and that's going to lead to a third and 11.
So, Brandon, when this offense gathers together to watch tape for this game, they're going to be feeling pretty good about themselves until the coaches get upset about the play we just saw. But you know their defense is going to be, but we put up big points all game long. The defense is going to win one every now and then.
Throwing now is Kaepernick. And Latimer's got it. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. And they pick up 25 as they convert on third.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Two Patriots there to bring him down.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
The 8th play of the drive coming up. It's 3rd and 3. And carry number 20 now for Roddy Hillman. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4th.
Oftentimes when a guy has a game like this, he's going to take his offensive line out to dinner afterwards. But after a play like that, he may tell him, instead of getting the steaks, guys, we might have to go for the hot dogs.
So it's three more points, and that widens things out even further here in the fourth.
Hey, in this league, you can never have too much. So if you're in range, grab the three whenever you can.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Screen pass to Blunt. And he's brought down. It'll go as a gain of 12. And that's good for a New England first down.
They ran that one well. And not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
And a diving grab. I think he got that. Yes.
I'd have to say that whenever you see a good post route run, they do not like to let it end without the catch. Hence, that great diving play.
Yeah, lay it up there, let him go get it, and he got it. Now they go screen, it's complete. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41.
Here we go now.
Garoppolo now, looking for Gronkowski, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they will take over at the 29-yard line. And the 49ers getting set to trot out there. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had a field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game.
Ronnie Hillman, nothing but green grass ahead of him. A big play there for the Niners. 44 yards on the ground. Big run here in the fourth as they continue to wear down this defense.
And that's when the offensive line coach clicks onto the headset and says, head coach, offensive coordinator, let my guys fire out and hit people. We're wearing them down. Let's finish them off with the running game.
Few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Two Patriots there to bring him down. So what will they do? On the ground, through the air, let's see. Second and nine.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
Second down carry for Ferguson. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of two. Now third down.
Hey, a lot of points have been scored in this game, but what a nice play by the defense. Stepping up on that one. Maybe they'll get things going in their direction after a play like that.
Check. Watch the D4. Watch the D4. Come on, baby.
Hey, 91. Check 91.
Kill. Tight door.
On third down, Ronnie Hillman. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. And Dawson's kick is good. And that will just add three more to a lead that's already out of hand. So a good kick there, and they finish off the drive with three.
And that should be the goal for an offense, finish each drive with points. So that's a nice job there to come away with at least something.
The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
They run from the pistol with Hillman.
And a short gain down to about the 33.
Time for a break. This one, all over but the shouting. We'll finish it after this. Now a handoff. It's Hillman. And he's brought down. And a nice carry there of 15 yards.
Well, I'd say that run's pretty emblematic of what we've seen all day long. No matter what they've done on offense, this offensive line has controlled the line of scrimmage, giving them time to throw it, run it, do whatever they wanted. That's why there are points up on the board. And right now, the psyche of the offense, we're in control, and we can do whatever we feel like doing out here on the field.
At each other right when he flinched. We knew that that flag was coming.
Yeah, offsides, easy call. Mark off the five and keep it moving.